The city of Flint made national headlines back in 2015 after dozens of Michigan residents were sickened and even killed by dangerous amounts of lead in their drinking water. Since then, multiple investigations have pointed to massive cover-up within the former Governor Rick Snyder administration. I have investigative journalist Jordan Chariton with me to talk about this. Jordan, first of all, let me begin by telling you, you have done a remarkable job covering this story when corporate media has paid no attention. I mean, it's as almost as if corporate media has an attention span of a fruit fly. And I just want to tell you, this is great coverage. Your report in The Intercept explains how hard it's been for investigators to get a hold of phone records relating to the Flint water crisis. What's going on with all this missing evidence? It looks really, really bad.
Yeah, so essentially there's been two investigations. One was the original starting in 2016. That was under a Republican attorney general. And that investigation and those prosecutors discovered Governor Snyder, his top officials, including his press secretary, their phones were erased shortly before the launch of the Flint criminal investigation. Those prosecutors also learned that top officials in the health department, obviously a health crisis, so kind of important, their phones mysteriously had no messages on them for all of 2014 through October 2015, which was the full period Flint used the Flint River for its water. They also were tipped off that officials with the state environmental department allegedly dumped their phones to the state IT department, and those phones came to IT wiped clean, was the quote.
Yeah. So we expected more from Dana Nessel. I mean, you know, matter of fact, I came on the show when she was announcing, like, this, they were going to really do something about it. Well, they did nothing. I mean, they dropped the ball knowing that, as you report, this Dr. Edwin Wells, this is their job, okay? Phone records just disappear. They've been wiped clean, even though they have a retention requirement of at least 1 year after, you know, and indefinite if there's an investigation going on. It's very clear somebody wiped the phone, isn't it? What explanation do they give for these text phone logs being just vanishing?
You know, as a journalist, you usually get spin from government and corporations. In this case, it was silence of the lambs. The health department literally said, we don't care to comment. When asked about, you have an explanation for, you know, a year and a half's worth of messages mysteriously being empty. The environmental department, currently under Governor Whitmer, basically pointed fingers at the previous administration, saying we can't speculate about what they did or their motivations. The governor's legal team has refused to answer. So nothing is being disputed in this story. You know, I think, you know, the mainstream media pretends you're all supposed to be neutral robots as journalists. I very confidently say this is the biggest government cover up this century, from the governor's office, health department, environmental department. It's crazy. And frankly, The current attorney general, Dana Nessel, she wiped clean. She fired the previous investigation, saying we're going to redo this thing and start from scratch and bring justice to Flint. They charged the governor with a misdemeanor when there's a lot of evidence here from our reporting.
She ran.
He knew about a lot of these things.
My memory is she ran under the idea we're going to play. You know, we're going to clean up this political cesspool. She's now part of that political cesspool. And you have to ask, how far does the chain of, where does this go? How far up the chain of command does this go? Where we know that they switched the water supply directly into Flint River. People were coming down with Legionella disease, dying left and right. Pediatricians were saying, we're seeing a trend here, children with being affected by lead somehow. And all this is just covered up. How far does this go up in the chain of command?
Well, our previous story in January showed that the governor, prosecutors had obtained the governor's phone calls with his chief of staff and health director in October 2014. Over 2 days, they spoke 22 times. And why that's important, this was the exact time that the health department and the environmental department were scrambling about the increase in Legionnaires cases, happened to be 2 weeks before Snyder's reelection. So the prosecutors concluded that was Snyder and his top officials trying to stop the news of the waterborne bacteria that was killing people from going public before his reelection. Snyder testified to Congress, he did not know about Legionnaires until a year and a half later. I can't even get Congress, now democratically controlled, to respond whether they will be bringing him back in. I think perjury is still a crime in front of Congress. It goes all the way up. There's also another element, real quick. The Flint water crisis, underneath it, was a financial fraud. It was a privatization scheme to build a new pipeline, take control away from Detroit's water system and make it regional. And the financial fraud behind this, Attorney General Nessel dropped charges that the previous investigation had charged against top officials for bond fraud. Those charges were mysteriously dropped and not brought back. So it stinks from the governor's office to the current attorney general's office.
Okay, so the point being, we you know, on this program, we always talk about how ridiculous tribal politics are. I'm Democrat, therefore I have to be all Democrat. I'm Republican because I have to be all Republican. Here, it's both parties, baby. I mean, both of them are part of an ugly, cesspool political process where children have been injured for the rest of their lives. People have died because of the decisions that these politicians made. There was one part of it that really intrigued me. They knew for 16 months that there was something going on with the water supply after they switched and had a new source. They knew for 16 months that Legionella was killing people, and they didn't tell anybody. Did I get that right?
Absolutely. And by the way, the governor's health department and environmental department knew about it right before his reelection. And Governor Snyder at that time, you know, in a galaxy far, far away before Trump ran for president, he was angling for president, but he had to get reelected as governor first. So it's very clear from our reporting that he knew about a deadly waterborne outbreak that was killing people. And not he didn't willfully, you know, the charges against him were for willful neglect of duty. It was the opposite. He wasn't neglecting his duty. He was acting along with his top officials to stop it from going public. People died. The previous investigation, our reporting and other reporters have backed this up. The original investigation was gunning for involuntary manslaughter against the governor. This one, so far, has charged him with a misdemeanor. It's the water, Jordan, is, if it's healthy, is clear. It's not red or blue. This shouldn't be about politics.
We're out of time, Jordan, but I want to end by saying this. You should get an award by this for doing this story, for following it. But in the real world of corporate journalism, unless you're talking about what Kim Kardashian wore to the latest celebrity event, it's not journalism. So I hate that that's where we are with corporate media nowadays, but that is where we are. This is great reporting. Thank you for doing it, okay?
Thanks for having me.